back to the channel, and today is going to be another like hiking, walking vlog, but I'm going to use this one today just to talk to you guys, my audience, because the channel has a lot of big things come up recently, a lot of big things coming up this year to like round off the year, and so it'll be something we can talk about together while walking down the Aber Valley, to say the least. But yeah, and also in this video I will be talking about something that I have looked into recently. I spoke to the guys about it and I'm going to give them a bit of a shout out, which is very suiting for this content. And the main thing is talk about what the content could look like in 2024. So today we are going to be walking up to a different part of the Eglwysyrin Common. I'm burping a lot in Aber Trydw and Syngenes. So now let's get into it. I'm gonna fall over. Right, the first thing I wanna go to before we go to the main part of the hike is where the site I am now. You can see behind me is all these fences. They are building houses by here, but this is the original site of the Windsor Colliery here in Aber Trydw. And in the trees over there, which I'm going to turn to my left now to head that way, is foundations of what's left of the old colliery, a couple of buildings and all that, maybe like the lamp room, I'm not sure. It's quite interesting to just have a look a little bit of that hidden in the trees. And while we're over there, I think we can talk about the Halloween video and what's coming up following up for that next Halloween, I suppose, because it's fair to say I think Creepy Tales from Wales really went down well. So let's just head over there and talk about it.
Right, top up and off the beaten trail. I think it's up here, someone told me. So, ow, the stingies. Bit of coal on the ground. Like slag heaps, possibly, I don't know. I'm sure it is up here, someone said. Or I could be totally going in the wrong direction, which is standard, because I have done in the past. I do feel like I should be sending back here.
Right. Wherever I am, if I'm not going in the right direction, this is quite a nice place. So I'll do Creepy Tales from Wales by here before we get to where we want to go. It was good, to say the least. How the response was, you guys seem to love the ghost stories of the castle of Llancaerchwawr, Taffwell, the urban legends of the Lady of the Lake and Land, Trisant, Malinot, and then the real-life horror stories, which I feel like I could have went Mercer and filmed a lot of my bits in Mercer. Seems I was in Mercer a couple of weeks ago, but I digress, so I will be doing Creepy Tales from Wales next year. Without a shadow of a doubt, I will be doing one next year. But the format of it will stay the same, where I'll do ghost stories, myths, and real-life horror stories. But the presenting is going to change. And I am open to ideas and suggestions for it. When I mean presenting is going to change, I'm not going to be mainly voice recording it. It will still be voice recording aspects. Don't get me wrong. I will be going to a lot of these places and be on the camera. And maybe change out and tell those stories in person more. So I had two stories sent to me via Twitter and Instagram. One of them is by this fella on Twitter called Celtic Druid, who's been quite a big fan of the content recently, and I think I am definitely going the wrong way. I need to turn back. But he sent me a story of a poltergeist haunting in Bargoed, happened in the 70s, so that is a story I really am interested in reading into it. So that will possibly, or 100% probably, be included in next year's Halloween video. And then probably, I would say, change camera. another one that was sent to me, which is quite local to Aber. It's only in Groeswen, which is the Mynydd Mawr Farm Banshee, which will fall into the urban legend category, which is even better because there's one for each next year. So if you do have any suggestions, my social links are on the screen now and in the bio. Drop me a message. I am more than happy to take on board your suggestions and we can go from there with Halloween. Let's go and bloody find this abandoned foundations and have a look at them before we go to the main
they
hiking
trail. In the distance by here. I'm guessing this part here, as you can see, is some foundations that's left from, I'll just use an example of a colliery building you've seen, coal mines, lamp rooms, and I'm going to fall over. Let's go up to it and have a look. So this is in a little bit more, it's only little foundations of a wall. I'm guessing it could lead into a building, but the colliery was built on a slant, the Windsor. More leading down our way, so we'll have a look down there before we go back onto the main trail. But the Windsor was linked to the Nangaru Colliery, which they, in I think the 70s or 60s, they've joined up the shafts underground, so you could potentially start your shift at the Windsor and end in Nangaru, vice versa. Let's have a wander down here quickly.
Suspect that I'm in a potentially what used to be a building or a walkway to a building is the ground back here. Paved. And somewhere just wooded over, don't really have paved ground. So we're going up through a bit of an opening which could probably reveal more of what it was here. It could have been a colliery site. Potentially, I don't know. So let's carry on having a look.
Seems to be more wall foundations by here, so I think, I'm not gonna lie, judging by the imagery I've seen, if I can pop one up on the screen, if I am correct, this could be one of the engine houses, the winding house I'm standing in, because it was, I'm sure it was built on the hill, so you can see where it ends, or just, could this be where track were, for the tramways, whatever. I don't know, it's quite fascinating where I am. Again, it's all paved, but you can see it's foundations by here. Again, this has probably got something massively to do with the Windsor Colliery. I do think this is probably what's left of it. The remains of some smashed up train over there. But what my argument is that this could be the Windsor Colliery site. It's a paved stone. Why would it be in an area like this? It's clearly overgrown and the grass is growing over it. I think down at the end of it. We'll head back and go on to the main trail now. No, I'm outside of what it is, but you can see this used to be a colliery building. I'm sure this, as I said, is the engine house. I'm stepping back very slowly. I have to, I'm sorry. But I'll get back to you. That long wall, it's gotta be like the pathway and then this by here. So I'm guessing the wheel was somewhere down by there. This is more the site behind those trees. Because it was built somewhere on the hill, but look at that. Hidden in the trees in Aber to do. You can't fault it.
Let's head to the main trail now. And we'll talk about something else while we head there. But it's quite interesting, to say the least. I'm not gonna lie, I'm surprised to hear that I was here. And what could be what's left of the colliery. This is quite cool over there. But let's just head to where we want to go and we'll carry on having a chat together, guys, before I fall over.
The thing with the Aber Valley, where I am, is it's a lot of natural springs and like brooks, streams. Because I think the name of our video, Aber Valley, is well for where three rivers meet. And now this is the waterfall by us. Go a bit further up to Avalok. I think I can go right up to it in fairness. And then we'll head back on the trail where we want to go.
So, I've gone off the beaten trail again, because of course, why not? And I thought I'll use this time when I head up to a waterfall now. Just gotta be careful, the cow over there do kind of make me a bit nervous, because they're heavier than me. And talk about the content for the rest of the year. Obviously, you'll know on Christmas Day there will be the Mercer Rising documentary. I'll get on to that a bit later on. But let's talk about what's coming out other than this video for the rest of the year. I'm hoping to get another two videos out this. Both will be exploring, but one will definitely be out this year. The one that'll definitely be out will be the Barry Ruins, which is all the ruins in the South Wales coastal town of Barry and Barry Island. If you're not familiar with Barry Island, I'll say Gavin and Stacey, and then you will probably be familiar with it. It has an abandoned castle there, ruins of a Roman villa. It has also an abandoned watchtower, a Victorian watchtower, and a World War II like fort. So like, the things are not big enough to constitute his own video separately. Because if they were big enough, there would be four separate videos, which is better, it's four separate con. But I still wanted to cover them and switch hands quickly. I can't hold the camera, here we are. And just basically still cover them and give it the life of its own, because a lot of them has got interesting stories. They've done research. I was meant to do it yesterday, but I think the weather's quite crap in Barry, so I didn't bother. And this video's been done instead. But that's one video. The other I'm hoping to get out is the Bryn Mawr CEMEX factory, which is an old Dunlop rubber factory used to make. I think rubber for like 10 trackets. So that'll be another video we'll be looking at, possibly at the end of the year or by early January, February time. I'm not sure yet, but we'll get on to the next one very shortly. But now let's have a look.
Well, I'm guessing it is a natural spring, because now look, the water is very clear. But it's quite interesting, that little building with the trees growing out of, a little building. It looks like a fireplace. If I zoom in on it, it looks like a fireplace. It's quite interesting, that's just hidden in the trees, and if I turn the cameras around, the pass I just came from, just down there, it's all here. Now I'm heading up to the trail, and people who recognise 1901 and 1913, this is the Universal Colliery graffiti art on one of the old railway bridges in St. Genevieve. So yeah, as you can probably notice, I've done two documentaries on this channel about it, and I do quite like this. It's quite nice, quite touching. But now we're heading up there on the hiking trail. You can see that's it straight ahead. There's a farmland halfway up. I have to cross through, which is part of the trail. In fairness to them, they're quite nice. They do lay you through. I've walked the dog up here before, so it is steep. I'm not gonna lie. But looking at that bridge has reminded me. Let's talk about the documentary next.
Okay, let's talk about what's coming out on Christmas Day. So you've probably seen it on my Instagram, Twitter, or even just the community page here on YouTube. It's the Mercer Uprising documentary. Yeah, that documentary is, of course, about the 1831 Mercer Uprising, which obviously made the master of Dick Penderyn, who is now a Welsh legend. And it is the longest documentary to date at 40 minutes by me. And there is one I am really proud of. Like, has elements of my previous documentaries in there with the Industrial Revolution, but I do visit a lot of the iconic locations of Mercer's industrial history. I need to hold it again like that. Hence, like Cyfartha Ironworks, Cyfartha Castle, what's next to the Iber Steelworks, which was the Dowlais Ironworks at one point. And then the iconic locations of Mercer at the town centre, Pontsan Bridge, etc. I have had this written since I was in March, started production in October of last season. But it will be out. I haven't set a time. I'm aiming to get up between 6 and 8 o'clock at night, personally. There will be little previews, there will be Instagram posts to promote it, and it could be the last documentary, because we had two this year, and I don't mean the last documentary ever. I mean the last documentary for a while, because the next one I have written, or I haven't written, I have written an intro and elements for it, is written and going to be made differently to the previous ones. Like, there's a lot more layers to it, to say the least. Had a lot more layers to the story I'm telling, and I do feel like it needs a little bit longer. It could be well over an hour, this talk, which is quite easily this next one, because I have found a lot of stuff that can be covered. So I do want to delay it, because I do want to get better camera equipment, get a drone camera, and get a new laptop. So you could be looking at about 2025 for that. I think I am approaching the farm that I need to cut through, because there's a trailer wagon behind me. It looks like a haystack wagon. So I'm just gonna walk further ahead, and I think it's time to cut to a sponsor.
Guys, you did hear right in the last section, I have got a sponsor, and today's sponsor is Deadly 66 Designs. Deadly 66 Designs is a goss jewellery and alternative bag sellers, which if you're into that stuff, like Halloween's just gone, you can get yourself some really, really nice spooky jewellery. I have seen the ghosts, they are pretty cool. But Deadly 66, if you're into the gothic designs, you can also get really, really strong, good quality bags, whether into the Tim Burton's A Nightmare Before Christmas, or into just the gothic skull, sugar skull styles. Deadly 66 can get a few. These are very, very good strong bags, which is suitable for school, camping, holidays, etc. If you are interested in any of Deadly 66 products so far, just to give you a heads up, they will be releasing Homeware very soon, which sounds really cool. Deadly 66 is based in South Wales and is a female-led business. So if you are interested in any of the Deadly 66 products, the link is down below and on screen right now. It's at Shopify. And the link is deadly66.shopify.com. And let's get back to the video. Right, I am approaching it. I can see the farmhouse ahead. I think one of the farmers probably drove past me, smiled and thanked me. So he's okay, I'm guessing, for me to pass through. Need to make sure, so I'll try and hopefully get this video finished. It does say there's a path, so clearly there might be okay for us crossing through.
Right, this time I wasn't allowed to pass through. Normally the woman at the farm did say, like, normally she would, because it is part of a hiking trail and all that, etc. But they have horses and cows out on the field because the weather is quite nice, and they didn't want them to get startled. Maybe a cow gets startled and go up, probably go towards me and I could get injured. Horses might bolt and run away and hurt themselves. They didn't want to risk that, so this is as far as we can go up, but I know there's another bit of a trail I want to show you anyway in a minute. And then we go from there, I would say, because there's a little bit more. I got one more section to add, and I got something to say at the end.
The long, steep walk back into civilization, back down to Singenis. Let's go. I did fall over earlier after going to like that little waterfall thing. That was fun. Like, I caught myself, just got the back of my trousers dirty. So let's just find another hiking path now, because I think it's one nearby that I could finish this video off with something interesting on it. So I can see it from round by here.
I am now at the turning circle in Singenis, and I think there's a tunnel down here. It's linked to the brook. Have a look at that. I did promise I'll try and find something else maybe we can end this video on, but I'm not sure. Let's have a look at that.
Right. We're back. And let's see what's under here. This is where I wanted to go for the turning circle to carry on with this hiking trail. I've seen it, never been under here, so I don't know what's under this tunnel. Looks like an old railway link bridge, not gonna lie. The Colliery for Singenis is behind me, is a National Mining Memorial. But what's by here? Absolutely nothing. Let's move forward. Let's carry on moving. We're by the falls. We're still in Singenis. I'm gonna get stung a lot doing this. So yeah, why not? Let's do it.
While I hike through like this bit of land with this tunnel behind me, let's talk about next year, 2024 onwards content, because there's a lot to cover. The standard series of exploring will go ahead as usual, and the hiking vlogs will go ahead, but with specials, I would say, at the least. Because I do want to do a lot more. Stingy. I'll get back to you now. I'm stuck. I am actually stuck in the stingy now. Let's digress. I want to do a little, like, travelling special. So, like, I want to go back to London next year. Probably do an exploring video in Notting Hill and leading up to Halloween before Creepy Tales from Wales 2 comes out. I want to do Highgate Cemetery. There's a lot of big people buried at Highgate Cemetery. I do want to cover stuff like that. And then I do want to also do more of the abandoned exploring. Like I said, if I can't do it this year, I will do like Semex Factory. Find a couple more abandoned things in South Wales, probably find a couple of things in England as well. I could quite easily maybe a couple of farmhouses, go back to how this channel started and carry on with that. Another special we'll be doing, because I said it will be no documentary this next year, will be an exploring video at Christmas, where I will be going around Bristol trying to look for Banksy's artwork. So you could be looking at that at Christmas 2024. And so on and so forth. We have still that style of content. So documentary will be coming 2025. I will be posting stuff, because it will be made throughout 2024 and 2025. So I'll be posting stuff to keep you updated about that documentary following the Mercer Uprising one. More content. Sorry, there's some coming. But I will be looking at doing more content, such as I want to start a stargazing thing, heavily inspired by Interstellar, not gonna lie. I'm gonna use Interstellar's inspired musical music from the film. Sorry, Hans Zimmer, Christopher Nolan. Chris, don't be angry, you are an inspiration, so please let me have Interstellar music at least, and new Hans as well. So I'll be doing stuff like that. Probably be looking at other ways to expand the content. I will, again, have to keep you posted for it, but let's try and go ahead a little bit. I talk about the last thing. I don't think I can go any further than where I am.
I mean, it does feel barren. You can see like where people are walking through. All right, I'm through these stingies at least. Oh my god, this is if this leads nowhere, I'm gonna be fuming, because that tunnel's by there. And yeah, god's sake, I think this is gonna go nowhere. personally do. Stingies are subsiding. Yeah, it's going nowhere. It's just woodland. Let's head back.
This video has been used for me just to talk to you. I know I've shown you a couple of cool things like the abandoned ruins of a building, some farm equipment left, a nice little waterfall. This barren wasteland with a cool tunnel going through it. But the point of this video, I was talking to you as a means of telling you what the channel update is and what's going on like with stuff in general on YouTube. So I have contacted this thing that's based in Aber Valley. I'm calling it a thing now, but I will be getting into it more, which is Men Talk Walk. I think I have that in the right order. I do apologize to you guys, but I have contacted them to give them a shout out. They are a group where men will meet up and talk about things while walking. It could be about your mental health, it could be about football results. It's just a nice, healthy way to speak up about things. I am hoping to like partner up with them in the future more, etc. Maybe do videos with them, maybe some more hiking vlogs. But if you do want more, I'm going to link their Instagram down below. Please check them out. They are doing a wonderful job. They are. It does help mental health. Like, I like doing hikes. This YouTube and this video has probably helped me with my mental health. Please check them out, and guys, I'll see you at the next video. Have a good one.